राम 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 सर्वेभ्यः हृत्पूर्वक नमस्काराः. वेलकम टू क्लास 85 ऑफ लर्न टू चैंट भगवद गीता वेबिनार. सो नाउ वी आर इन द 18th चैप्टर. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट 10 वर्सेस एंड वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू लर्निंग द वर्सेस ऑफ द 18th चैप्टर टुडे, द लास्ट चैप्टर मोक्ष संन्यास योगः. एंड वी हैव आल्सो सेंट आउट एन ईमेल लास्ट वीक ऑन रजिस्टरिंग फॉर द असेसमेंट. I have received a few questions which I have individually addressed on email, but a few frequently asked questions I'm going to address at the end of this class. And a few of you have said you have not received the email regarding the assessment. I have also sent you individually the email and the link to register. If there are more people who haven't received the link to register, please write to me on my email ID, which I will be showing at the end of this class. Please do write to me and I will send you the email to register. And one request is, all of you please take part in the assessment. At least reading, if memorization is a bit tough at this stage, at least reading I'm sure you all will be able to do. And like I've always been saying, reading is a skill you acquire. Even if you have started with the 18th chapter, that's fine. So as long as you go through the recordings and listen to the rules of pronunciation, etc., you will be able to read easily other chapters also. There is no need for you to have attended each and every class in person. Once you know the rules, general rules, and you go through the previous recordings, you will be able to read all the 18 chapters. So the last date for registering is April 2nd. Please, all of you, register if you haven't already done so. So let us begin. As usual, we will have a quick recap of previous classes' lessons, and then we are going to learn the new verses for today. गुरुरेव गतिर्गुरुमेव भजे गुरुणैव सहास्मि नमो गुरवे न गुरोः परमं शिशुरस्मि गुरोः मतिरस्ति गुरौ मम पाहि गुरो नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमम् देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम् अम्बत्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणीम् नमोस्तुते व्यास विशाल बुद्धे फुल्लारविन्दाय तपत्र नेत्र येन त्वया भारत तैलपूर्णः प्रज्वालितो ज्ञानमयः प्रदीपः मूकं करोति वाचालं पङ्गुल्लङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहौ वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवम् सर्वोपनिषदो गावः दोग्धा गोपालनन्दनः पार्थो वत्सः सुधीर्भोक्ता दुग्धं गीतामृतं महत् शान्ताकारं भुजगशयनम् पद्मनाभं सुरेशम् विश्वाधारं गगनसदृशं मेघवर्णं शुभांगं लक्ष्मीकांतं कमलनयनयोगिभिर्ध्यानगम्यं वन्दे विष्णुं भवभयहरं सर्वलोकैकनाथम् यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्र रुद्रमरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यै योगिनः यस्यान्तन्न विदुःसुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः धृतराष्ट्र उवाच धर्मक्षेत्रे कुरुक्षेत्रे समवेतायुयुत्सवः मामकाः पाण्डवाश्चैव किमकुर्वत सञ्जय ॐ श्रीपरमात्मने नमः अथ अष्टादशोऽध्यायः मोक्षसन्न्यासयोगः अर्जुन उवाच सन्न्यासस्य महाबाहो तत्त्वमिच्छामि वेदितुं त्यागस्य च हृषीकेश पृथक् केशिनिषूदन श्रीभगवानुवाच काम्यानां कर्मणान्यासं सन्न्यासं कवयो विदुः सर्वकर्मफलत्यागं प्राहुस्त्यागं विचक्षणाः त्याज्यं दोषवदित्येके कर्म प्राहुर्मनीषिणः यज्ञदानतपः कर्म न त्याज्यमिति चापरे निश्चयं शृणु मे तत्र त्यागे भरत सत्तम त्यागो हि पुरुष व्याघ्र त्रिविधः सम्प्रकीर्तितः यज्ञदानतपः कर्म न त्याज्यं कार्यमेव तत् यज्ञोदानन्तपश्चैव पावनानि मनीषिणाम् एतान्यपि तु कर्माणि सङ्गं त्यक्त्वा फलानि च कर्तव्यानीति मे पार्थ निश्चितं मतमुत्तमम् नियतस्य तु सन्न्यासः कर्मणो नोपपद्यते मोहात्तस्य परित्यागः तामसः परिकीर्तितः दुःखमित्येव यत्कर्म कायक्लेशभयात् त्यजेत् सकृत्वा राजसं त्यागं नैव त्यागफलं लभेत् कार्यमित्येव यत्कर्म नियतं क्रियतेऽर्जुन सङ्गं त्यक्त्वा फलं चैव सत्यागः सात्विको मतः न द्वेष्ट्य कुशलं कर्म कुशलेनानुषज्यते त्यागी सत्त्वसमाविष्टः मेधावी छिन्न संशयः We have launched the first 10 verses. Let us begin learning from the 11th verse onwards. At the end of today's class, again, I will be going to give you, I'm going to be giving you a brief overview of the assessment details. And like I said, answer a few questions which we have received commonly. So please register and take part in the assessment. Let us begin with the 11th verse. Charu, please unmute.
Ram Ram, ma'am.
Ram Ram Ram. Nahi deha bhrita shakyam.
Nahi deha bhrita shakyam. शक्यम् नहि देहभृता शक्यम्
त्यक्तुं कर्माण्यशेषतः
त्यक्तुं कर्माण्यशेषतः
यस्तु कर्म फलत्यागी
यस्तु कर्म फलत्यागी सत्यागीत्यभिधीयते
उत्तमम् सो ऑल ऑफ यू प्लीज नोट द महाप्राणस्य यस् नहि देह भृता भृ इज महाप्राण शक्यम हियर त्यक्तुम कर्माण्यशेषतः यू कुड कंबाइन द अनुस्वार आई मीन द संधि एंड चैंट इट एज त्यक्तुम कर्माण्यशेषतः दैट इज करेक्ट और ऑप्शनली यू कुड आल्सो चैंट द अनुस्वार कंप्लीटली यस्तु कर्म फल त्यागी भ महाप्राण सत्यागीत्यभिधीयते भ and dha both are mahapranas so both have to be chanted clearly nahi deha bhrita shakyam tyaktum karmanya sheshatah
nahi deha bhrita shakyam tyaktum karmanya sheshatah nahi deha bhrita shakyam tyak तुम कर्माण्यशेषतः
यस्तु कर्म फलत्यागी सत्यागीत्यभिधीयते
यस्तु कर्म फलत्यागी सत्यागीत्यभिधीयते यस्तु कर्म फलत्यागी सत्यागीत्यभिधीयते
उत्तमम् The dha also should be clearly heard as Mahaprana Charu. Next time, when you repeat, now the entire verse. Nahi deha bhrita shakyam tyaktum karmanya sheshatah yastu karma phalatyagi satyagityabhidhiyate
Nahi deha bhrita shakyam त्यक्तुं कर्माण्यशेषतः यस्तु कर्म फलत्यागी सत्यागीत्यभिधीयते
उत्तमं धन्यवादाः चारु वेल चैंटेड नेक्स्ट वन नेहा प्लीज अनम्यूट
अनिष्टमिष्टं मिश्रं च त्रिविधं कर्मणः फलम्
भवत् त्यत्यागिनां प्रेत्य
भवत्यत्यागिनां प्रेत्य न तु संन्यासिनां क्वचित्
हियर अनिष्टमिष्टं मिश्रं च सो यू कुड कंबाइन द संधि एंड चैंट इट एज मिश्रं च त्रिविधं कर्मणः फलम् अगेन त्रिविधं कर्मणः यू कुड कंबाइन एंड चैंट इट एज त्रिविधं कर्मणः एंड हियर विसर्ग फॉलोड बाय थ उपध्मानीय सो त्रिविधं कर्मणः फलम् भवत्यत्यागिनां प्रेत्य भ इज महाप्राण Natu sanyasinam kvachit. So here again you could combine the sandhi, chant it as sanyasinang kvachit. Both are right. And please note all the mahapranas clearly and the upadhmaniya here. And this is pronounced as phalam. Pha. It is not pha. In Sanskritam, we don't say phal, phalam. It is phalam, pha, not pha. Please note that.
Anishtamishtam mishrancha trividham karmana phalam. Anishtamishtam mishrancha trividham karmana phalam. Anishtamishtam mishrancha trividham karmana phalam.
Bhavatyatyaginam pretya natu sanyasinam kvachit.
Bhavatyatyaginam pretya natu sanyasinam kvachit. Bhavatyatyaginam pretya natu sanyasinam kvachit.
Anishtamishtam mishrancha trividham karmana phalam. Bhavatyatyaginam pretya natu sanyasinam kvachit. Neha.
Anishtamishtam mishrancha. Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, yes, I can hear you now. You could turn off your webcam if there's some connectivity okay. issue.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Yeah, chant.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes. Anishtamishtam mishrancha trividham karmana phalam. Bhavatyatyaginam pretya natu.
Okay, there's a lot of lag in Neha's voice. Dhanyavada.
Sanyasinam kvachit.
Okay, dhanyavadaha Neha. Uttamam, well chanted, but there was a lot of lag due to the connectivity, I guess. Next verse. Ishu, please unmute.
Panchaitani mahabaho. Panchaitani mahabaho. Panchaitani mahabaho.
Karanani nibodhane.
Karanani nibodhane. Karanani nibodhame.
Sankhye kritante proktani.
Sankhye kritante proktani. Tani sankhye kritante proktani.
Siddhaye sarva karmanam.
Siddhaye sarva karmanam. Siddhaye sarva karmanam.
Uttamam Ishu. Please note the mahapranas. Nibodha. Dha is Mahaprana. Sankhye. Kha is Mahaprana. Siddhaye. Dha is Mahaprana. Panchaitani Mahabaho. Karanani Nibodhame.
Panchaitani Mahabaho. Karanani Nibodhame. Panchaitani Mahabaho. Karanani nibodhame.
Sankhye kritante proktani. Siddhaye sarva karmanam.
Sankhye kritante proktani. Siddhaye अथये सर्वकर्मणा सांख्ये कृतान्ते प्रोक्तानि तिथये सर्वकर्मणा।
उत्तमम्, वेल चैंटेड। पञ्चैतानि महाबाहो कारणानि निबोध मे सांख्ये कृतान्ते प्रोक्तानि सिद्धये सर्वकर्मणाम्।
पञ्चैतानि महाबाहो कारणानि निबोध मे सांख्ये कृतान्ते प्रोक्तानि सिद्धये सर्वकर्मणाम्।
उत्तमं, धन्यवादाः इषु। नेक्स्ट् विहान्, प्लीज् अन्म्यूट्। अधिष्ठानं तथा कर्ता Vihan?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, I'll repeat this line. Adhishthanam tatha karta.
Adhishthanam tatha karta. Adhishthanam tatha karta.
Karanam cha prithak vidham.
Karanam cha prithak.
It's kshamyatam. Yes, it's karanam cha. Karanam cha prithagvidham.
Karanam cha prithagvidham. Karanam cha prithagvidham.
Vividhascha prithak cheshtah.
Vividhascha prithak cheshtah. Vividhascha prithak cheshtah.
दैवं चैवात्र पञ्चमम्।
दैवं चैवात्र पञ्चमम्। दैवं चैवात्र पञ्चमम्।
उत्तमं, प्लीज नोट, देयर आर मेनी महाप्राणास हियर। अधिष्ठानम्, ध एंड थ, बोथ आर महाप्राणास, वन आफ्टर द अदर, सो बोथ हैव टू बी चैंटेड क्लियरली। अधिष्ठानम् Tatha, the first ta is alpa prana, tha is maha prana. It should be chanted accordingly, clearly. And here, adhishthanam tatha, when you combine the sandhi, it becomes adhishthanam tatha. Karta, karanam and cha, when you combine, it becomes karanam cha. It is an optional rule. You can either combine or you can chant the anuswara completely. Prithagvidham, tha and dha. Both are mahapranas, so even that should be chanted clearly. Next line, vividhascha, dha is mahaprana, prithak, tha is mahaprana, daivam, again daivam chaivatra, daivam is here it is an anuswara followed by cha. Optionally you could chant it as daivam chaivatra, combining the sandhi. Panchamam, this word here is karanam. Sorry, by mistake I said karanam. It is karanam, it is not karanam. There is no dirgha there. It is karanancha. Please note again, it is karanancha, not karanancha. I hope that is clear. So let us some of you have asked me, is it karanam or karanam? It is karanam itself. It is not karanam, it is karanam. We'll repeat this. अधिष्ठानं तथा कर्ता करणं च पृथग्विधम्।
अधिष्ठानं तथा कर्ता करणं च पृथग्विधम्। अधिष्ठानं तथा कर्ता करणं च पृथग्विधम्।
विविधाश्च पृथक् चेष्टाः दैवं चैवात्र पञ्चमम्।
विविधाश्च पृथक् चेष्टाः दैवं दैवात्र पञ्चमं विविधाश्च पृथक् चेष्टा दैवं दैवात्र पञ्चमं.
Yeah, because we are splitting the sandhi, I mean, because we are pausing after cheshta, we chant the visarga completely as prithak cheshtaha. Because, I mean, some books, I'm sure the visarga is not given. That is, if you do not split the sandhi and chant it together, then it is fine. But here in class, we are following the rule of splitting the sandhi between padas. Therefore, we chant it as prithak cheshtaha. Uttamam, well chanted Vihan. I'll chant once again and you can repeat the entire verse. Adhishthanam tatha karta karanam cha prithak vidham vividhascha prithak cheshtah daivam chaivatra panchamam.
Adhishthanam tatha karta karanam cha prithak vidham vividhascha prithak cheshtah daivam chaivatra panchamam.
Uttamam, dhanyavadaha Vihan. Next, Suvarna Sudugoni Bhagini, please unmute.
Shariravang mano bhiryat.
Shariravang mano bhiryat. Shariravang mano bhiryat.
Karma prarabhate naraha.
Karma prarabhate naraha. Karma prarabhate naraha.
Nyayau va viparitau va.
Nyayam va viparitam va. Nyayam va viparitam va.
Panchaite tasya hetavah.
Panchaite tasya hetavah. Panchaite tasya hetavah.
Sharira vang mano bhiryat. Bha is mahaprana. Karma prarabhate, prarabhate, bha is mahaprana, nyayam va viparitam va. So both places here you have an anuswara followed by va. So here you could either chant the anuswara completely or optionally chant it as nyayam va viparitam va. Both are right. Panchaite tasya hetavah.
Shariravang mano bhiryat karma prarabhate naraha.
Shariravang mano bhiryat karma prarabhate naraha. Shariravang mano bhiryat karma prarabhate naraha.
Nyayau va viparitam va. Panchaite tasya hetavah.
Nyayam va viparitam va. Panchaite tasya hetavah. Nyayam va viparitam va. Panchaite tasya hetavah.
Uttamam bhagini. Now the entire verse.
Shariravang mano bhiryat karma prarabhate naraha. Nyayam va viparitam va. Panchaite tasya hetavah.
Shariravang mano bhiryat karma prarabhate naraha. Nyayam va viparitam va. Panchaite tasya hetavah.
There is a question whether there is a dvitvam here. Karma prarabhate. Yes, there is. Very good query there. Karma prarabhate. So there is that extra p there. So there there is a dvitvam karma prarabhate narah uttamam dhanyavadaha bhagini well chanted next verse priyadarshini bhagini please unmute tatraivam sati kartaram
tatraivam sati kartaram tatraivam sati kartaram
आत्मानं केवलं तु यः
आत्मानं केवलं तु यः आत्मानं केवलं तु यः
पश्यत्यकृतबुद्धित्वात्
पश्यत्यकृतबुद्धित्वात् पश्यत् यकृतबुद्धित्वात्
न स पश्यति दुर्मतिः
न स पश्यति दुर्मतिः न स पश्यति दुर्मतिः
उत्तमं भगिनी हियर् प्लीस् नोट् आल् आफ् यू तत्रैवं सति कर्तारं हियर् आत्मानं केवलं तु यः You could combine the sandhi and chant it as Atmanam kevalam tu yaha. It's optional rule like we always tell you. Either complete the anuswara or Atmanam kevalam tu yaha. Pashyatyakrita buddhitvat. Dha is mahaprana here. Nasa pashyati durmatihi. While chanting... While chanting Durmatihi, please do not prolong it as Durmatihi. It is not Durmatihi, it is Durmatihi. One of you has asked that a book has Pashyatyakrita Buddhitvan. So again, like I said, that is combining the Sandhi, it becomes Akrita Buddhitvan. But we don't combine the Sandhi here because we are pausing after each Pada. So whenever we pause, we follow the rule of splitting the sandhi mandatorily, which is what I told you in one of the previous verses also. Visarga at the end, we chant it because we are pausing there after the pada. So when we are pausing, it is advisable and we follow the rule consistently. Whenever we pause after the pada, we split the sandhi. So it is not an error in your book. They have combined the sandhi and given it to you, but we split because a new pada starts at na. So, Pashyatyakrita Buddhitvat is one pada. Next pada, Nasa Pashyati Durmatihi. So, please split the Sandhi and chant it there. Unless you are not pausing at all. In which case, you can chant without taking a breath after Buddhitvat. You shouldn't pause or take a breath. Then you can combine the Sandhi and chant. Okay, we'll repeat. Tatraivam sati kartaram. आत्मानं केवलं तु यः
तत्रैवं सति कर्तारम् आत्मानं केवलं तु यः सत्रैवं सति कर्तारम् आत्मानं केवलं तु यः
पश्यत्यकृतबुद्धित्वात् न स पश्यति दुर्मतिः
पश्यत्यकृतबुद्धित्वात् न स पश्यति दुर्मतिः पश्यत्यकृतबुद्धित्वात् न स पश्यति दुर्मतिः
This is S and this is Sh. Nasa Pashyati. Please differentiate that properly, all of you. Now I will chant the entire verse. What I would do is first time I would chant combining the Sandhi. So here actually even the first line we could combine and chant it as Kartaram Atmanam. So first time I will chant continuously just to show you the difference. Second time I will chant as is given in the on the screen. For learning purposes, it is always better to split and chant. But because you had a doubt, I will show you both. Then Priyadarshini Bhagini will repeat as is found on the screen.
Tatraivam sati kartaram atmanam kevalam tu yah pashyatya krita buddhitvan nasa pashyati durmatihi. So I hope you got the difference. I did not split after the first pada and after the third pada. So I continued chanting. Now we will chant by splitting as is given on the screen. Tatraivam sati kartaram atmanam kevalam tu yah pashyatya krita buddhitvat nasa pashyati durmatihi.
Tatraivam sati kartaram atmanam kevalam tu yah pashyatya krita buddhitvat nasa pashyati durmatihi.
Uttamam bhagini, dhanyavadaha. Now Charu again, please unmute.
Ram Ram.
Ram Ram. Yasya naham krito bhavah.
Yasya naham krito bhavah. Yasya naham krito bhavah.
Buddhir yasya na lipyate.
Buddhir yasya na lipyate. Buddhir yasya na lipyate.
Hatva pisa imam lokan.
Hatva pisa imam lokan. Hatva pisa imam lokan.
Hatva pisa imam lokan.
Hatva pisa imam lokan. Hatva pisa imam lokan.
Acharu, I don't know if I am hearing it that way, but I'm hearing it as himal lokan. I don't know, like I said, whether I'm hearing it like that, but just to clarify so that others do not get confused, it is not he, it is e. Himal lokan. It is not himal lokan. There is no her there. It is himal lokan. E. Okay.
Nahanti na nibadhyate.
Nahanti na nibadhyate. Nahanti na nibadhyate.
Okay, so now here. Yasya naham krito bhavah. Bha is mahaprana. Buddhir yasya. Dha is mahaprana. Na lipyate. Hatva api. There is a sandhi here. Hatva api. So the a gets replaced by this s sign called avagraha chinha. We do not chant the avagraha chinha, we just chant it as hatvapi. It's called purva roopa sandhi. Those who are attending regularly will know by now. Hatvapi sa iman lokan. Iman lokan, the sandhi is combined and it is chanted as iman lokan. There is a chandra bindu here, so that nasal tone should come. Nahanti na nibadhyate. Dha is mahaprana.
Yasya naham krito bhavah. Buddhir yasya na lipyate.
Yasya naham krito bhavah. Buddhir yasya na lipyate.
Buddhir yasya na lipyate.
Buddhir yasya na lipyate. Yasya naham krito bhavah. Buddhir yasya na lipyate.
Hatva pisa imal lokan. Nahanti na nibadhyate.
Hatva pisa imal lokan. Nahanti na nibadhyate. Hatva pisa himal lokan. Nahanti na nibadhyate.
Okay, now the entire verse. So while learning, request all of you to please chant slowly. So even the panelists request you to be slow in chanting, because it will be easier for those who are learning for the first time to follow each letter. So no hurry, we'll chant slowly. And again, I'm stressing on this, hatva pisa ima lokan. It is e, not he. So just to clarify to everyone, in case there is some confusion in what is being heard. Yasya nahankrito bhavah buddhir yasya nalipyate hatva pisa ima lokan nahanti nanibadhyate.
यस्य नाहंकृतो भावः बुद्धिर्यस्य न लिप्यते हत्वापि स इमान् लोकान् नहन्ति न निबध्यते.
Time was clearer, Charu. It was heard as E. धन्यवादाः. Well chanted. Next. Neha, please unmute.
Jnanam jnyeyam parijnata.
Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Jnanam jnyeyam parijnata. Jnanam jnyeyam parijnata.
Trividha karma chodana.
Trividha karma chodana. Trividha karma chodana.
Karanam karma karteti.
Karanam karma karteti. Karanam karma karteti.
Trividha karma sangraha.
Trividha karma sangraha. Trividha karma sangraha.
Yes, so here all of you please note. Jnanam jnyeyam. So here again we could combine the anuswara and chant it as Jnanam jnyeyam. So optional rule, either chant the anuswara completely or combine the sandhi. Jnanam jnyeyam parijnata. Trividha, dha is mahaprana. Karma chodana. Karanam karma. Again, same rule here. Anuswara followed by ka. You could chant it as karanam karma karteti. It is not karteti. There is no dirgha. So karteti, short vowel. Trividha karma sangraha. Dha is mahaprana. Visarga followed by ka. You get the pronunciation of jihva mulia. So, trividha karma sangraha. We don't chant the visarga completely. We chant it as trividha karma sangraha. Let us repeat.
Jnanam jnyeyam parijnata. Trividha karma chodana. Jnanam jnyeyam parijnata. Trividha karma chodana. Jnanam jnyeyam parijnata. Trividha karma chodana.
Karanam karma karteti. Trividha karma sangraha.
Karanam karma karteti. Trividha karma sangraha. Karanam karma karteti. Trividha karma sangraha.
Uttamam Neha, now the entire verse. Jnanam
jnyeyam parijnata. Trividha karma chodana. Karanam karma karteti. Trividha karma sangraha. Jnanam jnyeyam parijnata. Trividha karma chodana. Karanam karma karteti. Trividha karma sangraha.
Yes, so one of you has asked me, what is an anuswara? This jnanam, this dot which you see on top, jnyeyam, or this M which you see in diacriticals with the dot below, karanam, that is an anuswara in Sanskritam. If you are new to the class, you can always go through the previous recordings available on YouTube, especially if you watch class 50 or class 1. Class 50, directly we have gone to rules of pronunciation. Class 1 has some introduction, etc. So you could watch session 50 on YouTube, on our Vyoma YouTube channel, Learn to Chant Bhagavad Gita. There you will know the exact rules, what is Anuswara, what is Visarga, etc. So, but it's okay, as you, even if you just attend, say, two or three classes and concentrate in class, you will be able to understand these things because we keep repeating them. Dhanyavadaha Neha, well chanted. Next issue, please unmute. Jnanam karma cha karta cha. Issue, please unmute.
Shruyate va?
Am shruyate.
Jnanam karma cha karta cha. Jnanam karma cha karta cha.
Tridhaiva guna bhedatah.
Tridhaiva guna bhedatah. Tridhaiva guna bhedatah.
Prochyate guna sankhyane.
Prochyate guna sankhyane. Prochyate guna sankhyane.
Yatha vachrunutanyapi.
Yatha vachrunutanyapi. Yatha vachrunutanyapi.
So here, please note all of you, jnanam karma cha karta cha. So here, the anuswara followed by ka. So you could combine the sandhi and chant it as jnanam karma. That is an optional rule. Either you could chant the anuswara completely or split it as jnanam karma cha. Tridhaiva, dha is mahaprana, guna bhedatah. So bha is also mahaprana there. Prochyate guna sankhyane, kha is mahaprana, yathavachrunu, tha is mahaprana, and cha is mahaprana here. Tanyapi, p is a short letter, so please do not prolong it while chanting. I will just quickly highlight the mahapranas in the diacriticals also. Yes. Jnanam karma cha karta cha tridhaiva guna bhedatah.
Jnanam karma cha karta cha tridhaiva guna bhedatah. Jnanam karma cha karta cha tridhaiva guna bhedatah.
Prochyate guna sankhyane yathavachrunutanyapi.
Prochyate guna sankhyane yathavachrunutanyapi. Prochyate guna sankhyane yathavachrunutanyapi.
Is it karmam cha? One of you has asked. No, it is not karmam cha, it is karma cha. There is no anuswara there. It is jnanam karma cha karta cha. It is not karmam cha, jnanam karma cha karta cha. I hope that's clear. Now the entire verse. Jnanam karma cha karta cha tridhaiva guna bhedatah prochyate guna sankhyane yathavat shrunutanyapi.
Jnanam karma cha karta cha tridhaiva guna bhedatah prochyate guna sankhyane यथावच्छृणुतान्यपि
उत्तमम् इशु धन्यवादाः नेक्स्ट् वी हाव् विहान् नेक्स्ट् वर्स्
सर्वभूतेषु येनैकम्
सर्वभूतेषु येनैकम् सर्वभूतेषु येनैकम्
भावमव्ययमीक्षते
भावमव्ययमीक्षते भावमव्ययमीक्षते
अविभक्तौ विभक्तेषु
अविभक्तौ विभक्तेषु अविभक्तौ विभक्तेषु
तज्ज्ञानौ विद्धि सात्विकम्
तज्ज्ञानौ विद्धि सात्विकम् तज्ज्ञानौ विद्धि सात्विकम्
I think everyone is able to hear. One of you has said you're not able to hear. Please check the settings at your end because everyone else is able to hear. So maybe there's some problem at your end. Please do check. And here, Sarva Bhuteshu, Bha is Mahaprana. Yenaikam, Bhavam, Bha is Mahaprana. Bhavam Abhyaya Mikshate, Avibhaktam, Bha is Mahaprana. विभक्तेषु भ इस् महाप्राण तज्ज्ञानं तज्ज्ञानौ विद्धि ध इस् महाप्राण सात्विकम् हियर् अविभक्तं विभक्तेषु यु कुड् ईदर् चाण्ड् अनुस्वार कम्प्लीट्लि एस् अविभक्तम् और् यु कुड् चाण्ड् इट् एस् अविभक्तौ विभक्तेषु आप्शनलि बोत् आर् रैट् तज्ज्ञानं विद्धि और् तज्ज्ञानौ विद्धि बोत् आर् रैट् Please note that. Now we are going to repeat this verse. Sarva bhuteshu yenaikam bhavam avyayam ikshate.
Sarva bhuteshu yenaikam bhavam avyayam ikshate. Sarva bhuteshu yenaikam
अविभक्तौ विभक्तेषु तज्ज्ञानौ विद्धि सात्विकम्
अविभक्तौ विभक्तेषु तज्ज्ञानं विद्धि सात्विकम् अविभक्तौ विभक्तेषु तज्ज्ञानं विद्धि सात्विकम्
Here we do not prolong as vibhakteshu. We do not prolong that way. We make it a short letter because it is vibhakteshu. So we chant it short. So please note that while chanting. Now the entire verse.
Sarva bhuteshu yenaikam bhavam abhyayam ikshate avibhaktau vibhakteshu तज्ज्ञानं विद्धि सात्विकम्
सर्वभूतेषु येनैकं भावमव्ययमीक्षते अविभक्तौ विभक्तेषु तज्ज्ञानं विद्धि सात्विकम्
Uttamam Vihan, well chanted, धन्यवादाः I actually wanted to go a little further today, but I also need to deal with your questions regarding the assessment. So we will quickly revise the verses we learned today and then I will move to answering your questions regarding the assessment.
Nahi deha bhrita shakyam tyaktum karmanya sheshatah yastu karma phalatyagi satyagi tyabhidhiyate anish तमिष्टं मिश्रं च त्रिविधं कर्मणः फलं भवत्यत्यागिनां प्रेत्य न तु सन्न्यासिनां क्वचित् पञ्चैतानि महाबाहो कारणानि निबोध मे साङ्ख्ये कृतान्ते प्रोक्तानि सिद्धये सर्वकर्मणाम् अधिष्ठानं तथा कर्ता करणं च पृथग्विधं विविधाश्च पृथक् चेष्टाः दैवं चैवात्र पञ्चमं शरीरवाङ्मनोभिर्यत् कर्म प्रारभते नरः न्यायौ वा विपरीतौ वा पञ्चैते तस्य हेतवः तत्रैवं सति कर्तारम् आत्मानं केवलं तु यः पश्यत्यकृतबुद्धित्वात् न स पश्यति दुर्मतिः यस्य नाहङ्कृतो भावः बुद्धिर्यस्य न लिप्यते हत्वापि स इमान् लोकान् न हन्ति न निबध्यते ज्ञानं ज्ञेयं परिज्ञाता त्रिविधा कर्म चोदना करणं कर्म कर्तेति त्रिविधः कर्म संग्रहः ज्ञानं कर्म च कर्ता च त्रिधैव गुणभेदतः प्रोच्यते गुणसंख्याने यथावच्छृणुतान्यपि सर्वभूतेषु येनैकं भावमव्ययमीक्षते अविभक्तौ विभक्तेषु तज्ज्ञानौ विद्धि सात्विकम् सो वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड टिल दिस वर्स नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू आंसर ऑल योर क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग द असेसमेंट रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू प्लीज स्टे till the end of the webinar and just listen to what the assessment is going to be about. And firstly, I would like to tell you all to please register and take part in the assessment. Now, the greatest satisfaction for us at Vyoma is when we know that you all have learned because of the webinar and you're able to chant well. So that is the greatest satisfaction and fulfillment for us. That is the only thing we expect also. So it would be great to see you all, and we also feel that our efforts have paid off if we see more and more of you registering and more of you chanting and taking part in the assessment. So please, it's a humble request, an earnest request to all of you. Some of you are attending as a family. All of you take part in whichever mode you can, whichever assessment. There are three categories I've explained to you in the previous class. A quick recap, I've also sent an email last week. There you have the rules and you have the form to register. Now, this we already went through in the last class. It is exclusively for registrants of this course. The last date to register for the assessment is 2nd April. Please note this last date clearly. We are not going to entertain any registrations after 2nd April. So please immediately register, all of you. And as this is exclusively for the course attendants, then whoever has joined the course before 20th March will be able to register. Now, some of you have joined the course newly. Yes, please do register. The 18th chapter is a big one, 78 verses. Even if you attend all the classes from now, by the end of the 18th chapter, you will develop skills to read any chapter of the Gita. It's because the rules are common. And like I said, we have our recordings in the previous classes. Please go through YouTube or our course page and you will be able to register. I will resend the email with the registration link in a couple of days. For those of you who have registered newly, I will resend the email with the registration link. So you all can click on that link and register before 2nd April. Those who have already got the email, please bear with us for sending the same thing to your inboxes, because we have a group email ID and we have new registrants. We will have to send the email again to benefit those who have joined newly. And only online registration is possible.
rules, criteria, etc., we will be discussing in due course. And next, moving to the categories for assessment, memorization of all 18 chapters. I'm hoping at least a few of you do this. It would be great to see you all memorize all the 18 chapters. Then partial memorization, we have split it up into groups of 3 chapters. Each candidate can take part in up to 2 of these. So if you decide to take part in 13 to 15 and 4 to 6, you could do that. One is also permissible, but maximum of 2. Next, Parayanam, reading full, all 18 chapters, including Dhyana Shlokaha. This we are hoping most of you can take part in. In fact, everyone who is not taking part in either one or two categories should take part in 3. Because by now, you would have developed the skill of reading the verses. So we tell you the shloka number, the chapter number, verse number, the starting of the verse, you just have to read. So please try and do this, all of you. And only one you can choose, one of the 3 categories. Now, next, we have received a few common questions. So may I take part in more than one category? No. So either 1, 2, or 3 you can take part in. If you want to take part in partial memorization, in under that category, in any 2 slots, you can choose up to 2 slots. If you choose more than 2, then we will select the first 2, whichever you have chosen. But only 1 category allowed for taking part. Next one. Many of us attend from the same ID. So many of you have written to me saying that you have registered from the parents' email ID for the course, but your children are attending the course. That's perfectly fine. And also the username also need not be the same. Whichever email ID you have registered with for the course, it's okay. You can register with a separate email ID or same email ID on the registration form for the assessment. And I understand that some of you have registered from one account, but 4 or 5 of you are attending the class. All of you, please take part in the assessment. But make sure that you clearly indicate which candidate is taking part in which category. So you'll have to resubmit the form so many times. Say, supposing your daughter is learning, your daughter's name you please indicate on the form, which category, and submit. Then if your son also wants to take part, again repeat the process. You can use the same email ID for multiple registrations. But again, one candidate can take part only in one category. I hope that's clear. I have not received the email for assessment. New registrants, of course, you wouldn't have received it. We will send it to you again. Whoever has registered for the course in Sanskrit from home, all of you are marked on the email. But say, supposing you have changed your email ID or your email ID which you registered for the course is not functional anymore, in such cases, probably you wouldn't have received. Another possibility is that sometimes Vyoma mails go to promotions folder. So please check all folders, spam, promotions, whatever else folders are there. Please check all the folders to see if you have received the assessment email. If you've still not received it, please write to me. You can write to me on my email ID here, brinda.vyoma@gmail.com. Please write saying that I have not received the assessment link. I will send it to you. And please do it soon, because last day to register is April 2nd. If I don't reply, I'm receiving multiple emails. In case I don't reply within 2-3 days, please send me a reminder email again. I wouldn't mind. There's a possibility that I miss. So please send me a reminder email. The most common question which I received was, will verses be displayed on the screen for Parayanam, that is for reading assessment? Now, we had a very detailed discussion regarding this. And for multiple reasons, we have decided that we will not be showing the verses on the screen. Now, one of the most important pressing reasons for this is there is a lag in the internet. So the judge who is judging you, she or he might ask a verse, and sometimes even after the verse is displayed, there is a lag for you to see the verse. And due to connectivity issues, sometimes the screen sharing is not perfect, in which case it will just affect the assessment. So even if there are connectivity issues, if the audio is clear, once we tell you the number, the shloka, you can have your own book or soft copy and read. This is the most important reason why we decided it's not feasible practically to show the verses on the screen. And say for some group, there is some video issue. For that group, we may not be able to show. So we don't want that to happen. We want it to be uniform. So we will not be displaying the verses on the screen. Second reason is we want you all to become comfortable with reading your book, your version of the Gita, whichever you have. So once you practice with one particular book, it becomes easier for you to refer when we call out the chapter number. You can also do things like flagging the chapters, you know, with the flags, etc. in your book, so that whenever we call out, you will be able to quickly turn to that chapter and take out the verse. So all this you can do only if it is your own copy. Therefore, I highly encourage you all to start preparing with one copy of your book. Then, how do I revise for the assessment? A lot of you have said you have joined today. Some of you have joined, from the 10th chapter, 11th chapter. That's absolutely fine. Please go to our YouTube playlist. I will send you the link again by email. You can attend the classes from now on, and you will be able to register because you will be able to chant well. It is only in June, the assessment, so you have time. I've already addressed this question. I've joined the webinar late. Can I join? Of course, please do. I encourage all of you, and I'm sure you will all be able to do it. One way to do it is to go on listening. Go on listening to the chanting when you're working, driving, whatever. So it helps you. It gets registered faster. Then will mock tests be conducted? Yes, that will be in this webinar itself. I will send you the schedule. We will have mock tests, how I listen to you when you raise your hands for individual chanting. Now, one of you has asked me if it will get late if you look at your book. Well, will it take time for Parayanam? No. The answer is, if we start displaying each verse on screen, then there might be lags, etc., and it will get delayed. So therefore, we encourage you, like I said, if you have your own book, please flag the chapters. And you can do all that in advance. Also, if you get comfortable reading one particular text, it's easier for you to flip through and find rather than us showing it on the screen. We had a very detailed discussion. I just mentioned one or two reasons to you, but due to multiple reasons, we have decided to not show the verses on the screen. And also that each of you gets your own copy and reads from that. It is simpler for you and simpler for us also. When will we get the Zoom link? The Zoom link you will be getting only after we decide the date for assessment. We will group you into different categories based on time zones, etc., and then you will receive the link. We will not be showing any verses on the screen. No consolidated chapters of English and Sanskrit, but we have this document on the course page. If you go to the course page where you register for Learn to Chant Bhagavad Gita webinar, Sanskrit from Home, there we have already given you a soft copy of English and Sanskritam version of the entire Gita. If you want to use the soft copy, you could use that. You could download that and use it. There's a PDF available. Memorization partially, is Dhyana Shloka included? Oh, that we still haven't decided on that. I will get back to you on that, whether Dhyana Shloka is included in memorization partial. We'll get back to you on that, Bhagini. And if you have a book, that would be most handy. If you have a book and flag all the chapters. Which book? Any book by Gita Press Gorakhpur is okay. Any book would be okay. If you don't have a book, you could always download the entire Gita from our website, from Vyoma Sanskrit from Home. We have entire Bhagavad Gita there in Sanskrit and English. Please download the PDFs and you could either take a printout or use the soft copy and start learning. Does Parayanam include Dhyana Shlokas? Yes, it does. Parayanam includes Dhyana Shlokas. Assessment link, if you have not received, please send it to, please send me an email. I will also request the admin to put it up on the course page, but it is only for those who have registered for this course. Please note that. Ashish Mahodaya, the fact that you are in this webinar, that means that you have already registered for the course. Otherwise, you wouldn't have been able to log into the webinar. So once you log into this webinar, that means you are a part of the course. You will be able to register for the assessment with the link sent to you separately. You have to register separately for the assessment. There is no automatic registration from this course. So I hope that is clear. And so do we need to split the sandhi? That's up to you. Whether you split the sandhi or you chant, combining the sandhi is up to you. But either case, it should be done correctly. So that we would see. If you split, the splitting should be correct. If you're combining also should be correct. We don't follow, in Vyoma, we follow a proofread version. So these are all the proofread verses which we are giving you, and we follow certain consistent rules of splitting sandhi between padas. So that is how we have given you these verses. It is not a direct copy from any book. Of course the verses are the same, but splitting sandhi, etc., we have a certain mode. Like I said, if you want to use the same thing, please download the copy from Sanskrit from Home course page. So I hope this is clear. Thank you so much to all our panelists. How many shlokas will be asked to recite? All that we will be sending you the rules, etc., in due course. We will send you the rules, etc., in due course. We will tell you the verses. Those have to be chanted. You cannot choose your own verses and chant. We will tell you which verses, and those have to be either read or recited based on whichever category you're taking part in. So we have another webinar starting now, so I must conclude the class now. We will as usual conclude with Shanti Mantraha. Thank you so much, and hope to see all of you in the assessment. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pashyantu ma kashchid dukkhabhag bhavet. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Sarvesham Hritpurvaka Dhanyavadaha. Thank you so much. We will meet next class at the same time. Thank you to all our panelists also. Dhanyavadaha.